an Atlanta police officer indicted for murder. And damn it, he should have been indicted a couple of years ago. I've been on this case since day one, city of Atlanta. Let's put up the picture of the cop and his victim. He murdered the young Jimmy Atchison. This cop was part of an FBI task force. He literally committed murder in front of the FBI and nothing happened to him. Let me give you the background to this story. Now, before I get into this story, the father of Jimmy Atchison, good brother, his name is Jimmy. I just got off the phone with him. He's been advocating and fighting every single day. This man sends me either a text or an email every day of his life about this case. Finally, the district attorney did what she was supposed to do. Let me give you the background. For more than 3 years, Jimmy Hill has kept a weekly vigil, that's the father, outside the offices of the Fulton County DA's office. Think about that. Jimmy Hill, the father, has kept a vigil outside of the offices of the Fulton County DA, distributing flyers about his son's death at the hands of police demanding justice. This week, former Atlanta police officer Sung Kim was indicted on charges of felony murder, involuntary manslaughter, and violation of oath by a public officer in connection with the shooting death of 21-year-old Jimmy Atchison, which took place January 2019. Let me give you some more background. It's not clear if Officer Kim, who retired from APD, has an attorney. Now let me pause on that moment right there. He does this extreme murderous deed, city of Atlanta, they allow him to retire. That locked his benefits in. Even if the man is now convicted of murder, because they did not do exactly what they should have done, I'm talking about the department, immediately, taxpayers, including the father of Jimmy Atchison, will be funding this man's retirement package. There's more. Oh man, it has not hit me yet, Mr. Hill said. Mr. Hill is 60 years of age, said he learned of the grand jury indictment from his attorney earlier Friday. His family expects to hold a news conference with the members of the NAACP and their attorney on Monday. They've already done that as of this morning. Jimmy Atchison was shot and killed January 22nd, 2019 by the Atlanta police officer. Atchison was unarmed when he was shot in the face after a foot chase. Now, I want to remind everybody who may not be familiar with this story or you forgot some details. Not only was he unarmed, he received two conflicting commands. One command said, come out with your hands up. The other command said, don't move. He comes out with his hands up. Out of all the cops involved in this task force, it was only Officer Kim who decided to shoot him in the face, right in front of every other task force member. Nobody else on the task force thought Mr. Atchison was a threat. Nobody else shot him. So you have a cop who literally committed murder, in my opinion, in front of other cops and nothing happened to him. He was not immediately indicted. He was not immediately charged. Hell, he didn't even get immediately fired. All of the officers were aware of what happened. The young Jimmy Atchison posed no threat whatsoever. A father of two, bright individual. An investigation by the previous administration in the Fulton DA's office, that would have been DA Paul Howard, found the shooting to be unjustified and recommended the officer who killed Atchison be charged with felony murder. The previous DA said that. The officer has said he believed Atchison was armed, but investigators later confirmed he was not. The Atlanta Journal-Constitution previously reported. Officers were pursuing Atchison at an apartment complex while trying to serve him on a warrant. Now you may ask, well, wait a minute, the district attorney said the man needs to be indicted. What happened? Well, because Officer Kim was part of an FBI task force, it created a complexity that the previous DA could not overcome. He tried. He literally took the federal government to court, trying to bypass the immunity dynamic connected to the case. It was not until recently that the new DA was able to get through the barriers, and you have an indictment. All right, Ben, thoughts here?
Once again, you have red tape that makes justice so difficult to attain in this country. There's red tape that puts justice, puts a block in the way of justice when somebody who's unarmed gets shot in the face. That's how our laws go in this country. That's how it's set up. It's a travesty. And thank God this is finally heading towards justice, long, long deserved justice. If you look at any video of Mr. Hill, the man's father, the humanity just pours out of him.
That's right.
Seeing this man nearly 4 years now after his son's brutal murder, handing out flyers, trying to get outside the DA's office, trying to get people to understand the inhumanity, the horrible crime that happened. And it looks like at least he can hopefully start to breathe a little bit easier, knowing that his work is paying off and his honoring of his son's memory is paying off, because it's very, very hard to hold law enforcement to account in this country, as we see time and again. But sometimes justice does come, and let's hope that it goes all the way through to a conviction of murder against this officer, shooting an innocent man in the face. That needs to be rectified. We need more stories that end up this way, and it needs to not take 4 years. The toll on a man having to deal with a lack of justice for 4 years. And there's many other cases in this exact same police department that are unjust murders of family members. And so hopefully this leads to getting rid of some of that red tape and getting us more towards justice as a norm and not the exception to the rule.
That's right. Well said, brother. You made a very insightful observation. The humanity of Mr. Hill shows in everything he does. Today was the first day, and I didn't realize this, Ben, until I spoke to him in the context of an indictment for the man who murdered his son. For the first time, I heard some level of relief in his voice. For years, he has always spoken in a tone that was indicative of a hurting father, rightfully so. Today was the first time I ever heard the brother actually seem as if he can take a breath.